Was the night before Christmas. He lived all alone in a one-bedroom house made of plaster and stone. I had come down the chimney with presents to give and to see just who in this home did live. I looked all about, a strange sight I did see. No tinsel, no presents, not even a tree. No stocking by mantle, just boots filled with sand, and on the wall pictures of far distant lands with medals and badges. Awards of all kinds. A sobering thought came to my mind. For this house was different, so dark and so dreary. The home of a soldier, now I could see clearly. The soldier lay sleeping, silent, alone, curled up on the floor in this one-bedroom home. The face was so gentle, the room in such disorder. Not how I pictured a United States soldier. Was this the hero of whom I had just read? Curled up on a poncho? The floor for a bed? I realized the families that I saw this night owed their lives to these soldiers who were willing to fight. Soon around the world the children would play, and grown-ups would celebrate a bright Christmas day. They all enjoyed freedom each month of the year because of the soldiers, like the one lying here. I couldn't help wonder how many lay alone on a cold Christmas Eve in a land far from home. The very thought brought a tear to my eye. I dropped to my knees and started to cry. The soldier awakened, and I heard a rough voice. Santa, don't cry. This life is my choice. I fight for freedom. I don't ask for more. My life is my God, my country, my core. The soldier rolled over and soon drifted to sleep. I couldn't control it. I continued to weep. I kept watch for hours. So silent and still, and we both shivered from the cold evening's chill. I didn't want to leave on that cold, dark night, this guardian of honor, so willing to fight. Then the soldier rolled over with a soft voice and pure, whispered, "Carry on, Santa. Christmas Day, all is secure." Well, look at my watch, and I knew he was right. Merry Christmas, my friend, and to all a good night.
So